So today we are of course doing a special episode on Tesla's Battery Day. And wow, was Battery Day insane? There is just so much to talk about.
But there are of course also some letdowns. Some people even go as far as to say that Battery Day was a disappointment. For example, the Model S Plaid reveal.
So what now? Was it a disappointment or not?
We'll go through the most important points and of course what this will mean for the future of Tesla and electric cars in general. So I'd say let's start right away.
So then, Battery Day. It was freaking epic. Those who say that it was underwhelming or even a huge disappointment, yes, believe it or not, there are people saying this. Those people have no idea what they are talking about. What Tesla did here was nothing less than showing us the total disruption of the battery world and a clear roadmap to total electric car world domination. Yes, you've heard that right. Total world domination by 2030. That's what Battery Day was really all about. So let's start to recap the most important points.
Elon kicked off the Battery Day event by showing us this graph here, which is really super important. Namely, the price per kilowatt hour, which he says is dropping too slow now. And this really needs to be accelerated because we need to shift to a renewable economy and sustainable transport as soon as possible. So this is the main motivation. To this end, Tesla unveiled an amazing 5-step plan in order to reduce the cost per kilowatt hour by an astounding 56%. Yes, a reduction of battery price by more than half. But of course, not only that, but also to at the same time increase battery energy density to allow much higher range and to drastically reduce the price of a new Giga, or better, Terafactory. So that Tesla can pump out 20 million cars per year by 2030. Just as a comparison, that is twice the annual output as the largest legacy car makers have today. So how does Tesla want to achieve that goal? Well, it's a 5-step plan. The first piece of the puzzle is the new cell design. They call it the 4680 cell because it's 46 millimeters in diameter and 80 millimeters in height. It will employ a tabless electrode, the first of its kind, which has 5 times more energy, 6 times more power, and allows for 16% more range than the current Tesla battery cells, and a 14% reduction in price per kilowatt hour.
In the second step, Tesla plans on optimizing cell production itself. Elon always says that it is much harder to build the machine that builds the machine. And to that end, Tesla showed us a new prototype cell manufacturing line. Here, they include Maxwell's dry electrode fabrication process, of which they say it doesn't work super perfectly yet, but they are confident to get it working properly with high yield in the next 1 to 2 years. They showed us a fascinating clip of the high-speed continuous assembly line, where one single line can output 20 gigawatt hours, which is a 7-fold increase over current cell production lines. Crazy! This, coupled with Tesla's power electronics fabrication, will allow for a reduction of 86% in formation investment and 75% reduction in formation footprint. This is huge because this basically means that Tesla's future factories will be able to output 7 times the battery capacity output than today's gigafactories, with an even smaller footprint. So the future Tesla Terafactories will be smaller than today's gigafactories and output an insane 1 terawatt hour annually. Wow! And here they dropped the bombshell. They want to scale to 100 gigawatt hours by 2022. Currently, Tesla is around 50 gigawatt hours per year, by the way. But by 2030, they want to output 3 terawatt hours annually. So 60 times more than today and 30 times more than in 2022. This means nothing less than total electric car world domination.
This corresponds to an output of 20 million cars per year, which is about the output of the two largest car makers, Toyota and VW combined. Elon said that 20 terawatt hours are needed annually by 2030 to be able to replace all stinking ICE cars, buses and trucks on the road worldwide as fast as possible. Because today there are still around 2 billion of these stinkers on the roads worldwide. So there's still a lot to do, and Tesla cannot do it alone. Other car manufacturers will be needed to achieve that goal together with Tesla. Hence, this second step also leads to a reduction in price per kilowatt hour of another 18%. Now 32% for the first two steps combined.
And please consider subscribing to our channel, because we are a dying breed. We are one of the very few channels who cover spaceflight and SpaceX news, but at the same time also disruptive technologies such as electric cars.
And we really need your support, because the YouTube algorithm doesn't like it when your channel covers a broad range of topics. So we would be extremely thankful if you could tell YouTube that you are interested in disruptive technologies by subscribing to our channel.
The third step are the anode materials. Tesla will use a process they call elastic iron conducting polymer coating to enable a higher density and much cheaper silicon electrode design, leading to another 5% reduction in price per kilowatt hour. Then regarding the cathode, they will maximize nickel content and completely remove cobalt from the batteries. This leads to another 15% cost reduction per kilowatt hour. But this will also massively reduce the environmental footprint, because a lot of intermediary steps fall away, which means zero waste water, minus 66% investment costs, and minus 76% process costs. And then, of course, the lithium. Elon emphasized that there's still a lot of lithium on Earth, and Tesla has secured a lithium site in Nevada, which has enough lithium to convert all cars in the US to electric. That is how much lithium there is only at that location. To that end, Tesla will introduce a sulfate-free process, further reducing lithium cost by 33%. Then, as if that wasn't enough, Tesla will also recycle the old batteries to regain lots of valuable resources from the old batteries. This would lead to another 12% reduction in cost per kilowatt hour. Thus, the first four steps already reduce costs per kilowatt hour by an incredible 49%. But that still didn't seem to be enough for Tesla. So they introduced step 5, namely cell vehicle integration.
The logic here is to use the mechanical properties, the rigidity of the battery pack itself, and integrate it into the chassis of the car, such as to make the whole car more rigid and mechanically stronger. The new casting method will play a big role here, reducing the parts per car by 79 parts and saving 40% in underbody costs. The future battery will be then cast into the chassis itself, making the battery a seamless part of the chassis. This leads to a 10% mass reduction, a 14% range increase opportunity, because you can just pack more battery into the same volume, and 370 fewer parts. Of course, this also will reduce the investment cost into a future gigafactory by as much as 55% per gigawatt hour, which is just crazy, and allow for a 35% reduction in floor space for a new factory. And this last step then finally leads to another 7% cost reduction per kilowatt hour. So all five steps will reduce the price per kilowatt hour by 56%, which is just crazy. So from today's around $120 per kilowatt hour down to $53 per kilowatt hour. Tesla's Roadrunner facility at the Fremont factory is the prototype which will show that these five steps are possible and will already output 10 gigawatt hours per year by 2021, which is really amazingly fast. Elon wants to have this ready in the next 2 to 3 years for mass volume production, so in all giga, or more precise, tera factories. Combining all this, we will in a few years see Teslas with 54% more range, with batteries costing 56% less and a new gigafactory costing 69% less upfront investment. This is just insane. The new cost per kilowatt hour curve will thus look like this here, enabling much cheaper EVs with more range than today. And then Elon dropped a giant bombshell, because this will enable a $25,000 sub Model 3 compact car. This is the ICE car killer we've all been waiting for, and Tesla wants to bring it out already by 2023. They didn't reveal the design yet, but we know some sketches already from Giga Shanghai's design center job postings. So this car will probably have a range of at least 300 miles, possibly even more, will have full self-driving capability and cost only 25K. Rest in peace, ICE car. This will be it, the final death blow to the ICE car, and it will come already in 3 years. Sooner than many expected. This will be Tesla's most important car to date and the total game changer we've all been waiting for.
But of course, the new batteries will also be needed for Tesla's other products. First and foremost, the Tesla Semi, which will need a battery pack of 1000 kilowatt hours. Then, of course, the Cybertruck, which will have a 500-mile range, as you can remember from the presentation last year, in the tri-motor configuration. And of course, the next-gen Tesla Roadster, which will have an insane 600-mile range. But for people who don't want to wait until the next-gen Roadster comes out, Elon introduced the Model S Plaid. Bam! 520 miles of range, less than 2.0 second acceleration, 0 to 60, and 1,100 horsepower. These stats are just crazy. And just 2 weeks after the Lucid Air unveil, the Model S Plaid basically destroys the Lucid Air in all performance metrics and even regarding range. And the Model S Plaid will cost 139K, a similar price point to the Lucid Air. But that is the only thing where we are a bit disappointed, because we expected the new Model S Plaid to also feature an updated design. But it appears that the exterior as well as the interior design remain unchanged from the current Model S. But hey, that is just our opinion. You know, we like more futuristic exterior designs and think the Model S already looks a bit dated. But many still like the look. So this is of course a very subjective opinion. But still, the stats are so insane that the disappointment is not really large. And all in all, we have to say that the event was amazing.
Tesla showed us a clear path towards total ICE car destruction and total electric car world domination by 2030 and nothing less. So please don't be disappointed because no amazing products were unveiled live on stage. The long-term implications of this presentation are really historic and nothing short of world-changing. In 10 years, we will look back to this day and tell our children, look, I lived in the age of giants like Elon Musk. I lived to see the transition from internal combustion engine cars to electric cars. And this day, this presentation was the key to enable this profound change. And if you missed our last week's disruption report, where we talked about the Lucid Air, which could be the only real Model S competitor, you can watch this video here.
So thanks for watching the JS disruption report. And I would say, on to the future.
Why are you looking so serious?
Because I'm trying to remember what I wrote.
Yes. Now the outros.
Yeah.
Can you see a word where why we think it's a worthy competitor or it doesn't matter?
No, it's too long.